Good evening. This is Heavy Metal Rock Disproves the Old Earth and Proves the Creation of the Earth by God. Part 2. I have a lot of comments and a lot of things that people argue about with me. And one of the arguments was, well, you used aluminum foil, and when you bend it in, you get air in it. Well, okay. I bought this evening a pure solid aluminum, or maybe it's better on this side, yeah. A solid aluminum rod. It's solid, it's hard, it's solid rod. Here. It's aluminum, because I bought it just for the aluminum part. And I took off of this a piece of it. It fitted here. And I can do it again if you like, I mean, that's no problem. And I can do this test again with solid, dense steel. Aluminum is not so high. It's about 2.74 kilogram per liter. I hope, well, you can see it's pretty stiff to get it off. But here it comes. Yeah, this is another piece of it. So, showing you that I'm not faking the whole stuff. Here is a glass again. Here is the honey again, and it's pure honey just from the shop. Well, of course we ate some. This is just from the shop, and I did add no water to it. It's pure honey, and I will show you that aluminum, even if it's massive, this is massive aluminum, it still floats. In this case, on honey. And yeah, in some respect, this is a silly experiment. I agree. But it's only to show you a proof of principle that lighter elements, lighter metals, lighter minerals will float on top, and the heaviest will sink down to the core of gravitational attraction. Well, this is aluminum and this is aluminum, and both pieces will float. They're solid, you can see it here, they're solid, and it floats. Sorry folks, it still floats. And you may be lucky, it may be slowly sinking, but up till now it didn't. Yeah. And yeah, this is a little bit of a silly experiment. I agree. But it shows you that lighter elements or lighter minerals are floating on top of a heavier liquid. In this case, honey. Yeah, of course. I couldn't get a liquid lava. They don't sell that in supermarkets. But what I needed was a thick, viscous mass approaching hot molten lava, as the nebula, your beloved Nebula Theory, claims it has happened. Well, in that case, if that is true, then the lighter elements and the lighter minerals would float on top, and the heavier elements and the heavier minerals, mainly consisting of heavy metals, would sink to the core. And yes, it's slowly sinking to the bottom. Yeah, very slowly. Not as the copper coin as I showed you. You saw it. It's very slowly sinking to the bottom. I agree. And it proves the same thing, that lighter elements, lighter minerals, stay on top, and it's heavier. You saw that copper coin. I don't need to repeat it. I could, but I don't. It immediately sank. Yeah, And you saw that the aluminum stuff, like this, it is slowly going down. Yeah. So what you see is a differentiation in going to the center and even staying more on top. You see it very slowly sinking. Yeah. Well, if minerals are light, they stay on top, and if they are heavier, they sink. Yeah. Okay. And the heavier they are, they sink easier. Simple as that. I proved you the last time that the copper coin was sinking very much faster than you see it here, sinking. Well, if the nebula theory is correct and the Earth started as a hot molten mass, then the heaviest metal will sink in the first place and the rest will remain on top. Simple as that. The lithium elements, the beryllium, no, the Be, that's beryllium, no, it's not beryllium, is it? The sodium, the potassium, the calcium, and all those elements, magnesium, aluminum, they're very pretty light in contrast to the rest. They will stay on top, and also the minerals that are pretty light. So I showed you the principle, and of course this is a silly experiment. I agree, that's not, but it's a proof of principle, not. Of course, I cannot here have hot molten lava. If you would, then you have to have test it to the full. Then you have to have a big jar, make it really hot, about 2000 Kelvin, and put all kinds of minerals in it and see the same principle. Yeah, but the main principle is that the lighter stuff remains on top and the heavier sinks to the bottom. It's logical. Yeah, and that's what I wanted to show you in this. Kind of test. Of course, I agree, it's a little bit of a silly experiment, but I have no hot molten lava here. And honey, well, it doesn't come close, but it's thick and it is viscous, and it's well, from itself, based on the sugar content, it's heavier than normal water or whatever kind of stuff. Yeah? So, this is part two, and I showed you that even aluminum, which is denser, or which is solid aluminum, is also floating on top and then slowly sinking. Yeah. Okay. Maybe in the bubble in the folded aluminum, there might have been a little air, as Vox Nulla correctly said. So okay, that might have influenced it. But you see that the same principle goes for solid aluminum. The same principle goes, it floats and then it slowly sinks, as you saw. Okay, that was my thing, and it disproves the nebula theory, folks. It really does. The heavier elements would sink to the bottom directly, as the copper coin did in the last time, in the last experiment. And so would the heavier elements, but also the heavier minerals. They would sink to the core of the Earth and remain there. They would not get on top. Sorry for you folks, whether you like it or not. And so it disproves the whole nebula theory, because comets or meteors coming from out of the side of the Earth would easily break the lighter elements, minerals, because they have no really hardness, any hardness on them. It's pretty soft in contrast to heavier elements, minerals. So okay, this is the point I wanted to make, and you can make obnoxious remarks. I don't care. I really don't care, and I don't care for how my credits among you folks. I really don't care. I really don't care what you think of me. Call me names, whatever. I forgive you. But the science remains. Yeah? Okay, folks. This is what I wanted to tell you. Adios.